Hallelujah. Let us stand for prayer as we start our prison, our song service rather, in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for being with us from morning until now. The praises went up and the blessing came down. And Lord, we are here once more to finish the Sabbath. And we are here to send up some more praises. And we are anticipating that special blessing that you will be pouring out upon us. As we are about to have our song service, Lord Jesus, I pray that you touch our lips that we may sing to the glory and honor of your name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I'm inviting you all to come along. We are having a glorious time. We're going to a city where moonlight never shine. Oh, you may not know, you cannot tell, if others will be there. But God himself will be a light to guide us on our way. Oh, you may not know, you cannot tell.
better than this. Oh, what joy, what bliss. I love them. Everybody say, hey, amen. God bless you.
Can anybody hear me? So Granville, it really looked like somebody alone supposed to talk this evening, you know? Cause your mic not work. Okay, all right. Hi, everybody.
Happy Sabbath. Happy Sabbath, everyone. Ready? If you weren't ready after that song service, well, no, I'm not going to say that. I'm never going to say that.
I have a whole heap of getting ready to do.
But China, why you look so nervous? Are you a church listener?
Because I'm nervous. I'm nervous. I'm right, very nervous.
Since you're nervous, this one thing that you must do whenever we are nervous, and that is pray. So let's just pray to begin. Father in heaven, I want to thank you so much for today and all that you have done for us. I want to thank you for the gift of singing, something that you have blessed your people with as much as you have blessed us with the ability to understand and to preach your words. So Father, as we sing to your glory tonight and this evening, we pray that our hearts will be drawn closer to thee and that the words that we hear today will empower us to work for you this week. In Christ's blessed and holy name I pray.
Amen. 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 Can anybody tell me the title of our AY service today? Hold on. So some people know and some people don't know. For those of you who know, what is our title for our AY service this evening? So the second coming, our journey home. So we're winging it right? We're winging it now. So the second coming, our journey home. Wow.
Granville, you keep on looking at Granville like, yes. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, with Christ in the vessel,
we can smile at the storm.
All right. So do we go straight into the program?
I think so, yes.
You see, one thing I love about music is that music correlates so well with scripture. And here's what I want. Can someone find a scripture verse that relates with this song title, The King is coming. Can anyone find a scripture? You don't have to find it in the Bible, off the top of your head, paraphrase it, but just want you to say it.
But while we're doing that, Granville, can we talk about the Song of Glory?
What is the Song of Glory?
You know, I don't know, but I think Fortified wants to tell us what that Song of Glory is. I think Fortify wants to tell us.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. Happy Sabbath, everyone. Are we all looking forward to the resurrection morning when Jesus comes for us? No more crying, no more dying, no more pain, no more sorrows. And while Satan continues to get in the way, we have to prove to him that we serve a mighty God.
Amen.
Who can change any situation for the better. And while they check the email that was sent last night with the track from Carissa Hansen 12 at yahoo.com, I think...
Son of man, son of righteousness, you have poured your grace on me. Love falls down, lifting up my heart sings out your praise.
Let the seasons out, let the oceans roar, with the song of glory for you, Lord. Let it fill.
Runs to my deep
oh Lord, endless life of a thousand dreams. You have shown your grace to me.
Let the seas resound, let the oceans roar with the song of glory for you, Lord. Let it fill the sky, saturate my life with the song of glory for you, Lord. Sound of your strong melody, break the chains as it rises in me, as the heavens sing loud in the chorus of love. I will lift up my voice and cry out, from my soul I will send up a shout. Let the words of my life be the song you hear. Let the seas resound, let the oceans roar with the song of glory for you, Lord. Let it fill the saturate my life with the song of glory for you, Lord.
With the song of glory for you, Lord. With the song of glory for you, Lord.
Then row and row, they'll fall in line,
their perfect garments pearly white. They'll march in and claim their own land, where home at last the king will say, these are my own, for these are they, washed white in the blood of the Lamb.
The mighty band will start to play the hallelujah chords that day. All glory to the King of all kings. Then tears of joy will start to flow, because I've chosen to be there when the saints start to sing. The trump will sound, amens resound, the saints will rise up from the ground. Such singing and shouting,
Granville. I was nervous before, you know, but me excited now. Me very excited. Resurrection morn.
You have been resurrected.
So it seems.
You know, the beauty about this evening, you see, is that we know where we are today.
Yes.
But today we want to focus on not today nor next week or probably next year. Mm-hmm. But we want to focus on the next millennium. And we are talking about going home. You know, I said when Sabbath finished, now we are go home and then come back with social. But this home that we are going to, there is no coming back, because this will be our eternal home.
Yes, our final destination.
I listen to the song, and the song says that we are going to sing and shout, we are going to sing Amazing Grace. What's the first thing that you think of doing when you see Jesus? What's the first thing? What have you thought about? Anyone? Anyone think about it yet?
Exactly. Run and hug him and drop on my knee and say, Lord, thank you, Jesus, me reach.
I know enough time to think about it. I'm saying to myself, how everybody want to run and hug up Jesus? How that I go? I know one or two people, you know, the scripture says that as many as the sands of the seashore. So if everybody run up, you wait. I'll probably wait 1,000 years just to get my look at one hug, but I'll wait. All right? Now, it's big enough to get. Amen? No, Miguna, I homework, you know. Anybody did it? I asked you to find a Bible verse at what?
That tells us that the king is coming.
Zechariah 9. What it says. Anybody can help our dear sister? Zechariah 9, what it says?
Zechariah 9:9.
What it says? Amen, amen. And of course, that sounds like a prophecy pertaining to Jesus when he was going to Jerusalem, correct? Amen. I know the first Psalms that came to my mind when I look at the next song was Psalms 24, verse 7 to 10. And it says, "Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors." And what?
The King of glory shall come in.
And who's coming the next song?
For him.
For him. Hold on. We are singing for him, or for him is coming. What is it?
For him is coming to sing
the king.
The king is coming.
All right, hold on.
You know, we need to ask them.
So for him
is coming to sing for him.
So for him is coming to sing for him that the king is coming.
Is coming, yes.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, we introduce for him. The king is coming.
Marketplace is empty, no more traffic in the streets. All the builders' tools are silent, no more time to harvest wheat. Busy housewives cease their labor, in the courtroom no debate. Work on earth has been suspended as the king comes through the gate. The king is coming. The king is coming. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. The king is coming. The king is coming. Praise God, he's coming for me.
Happy faces line the hallways, those whose lives have been redeemed. Broken homes he has mended, those from prison he has freed. And
children and the aged, hand in hand stands all aglow.
Those who are crippled,
I know I'm holding heaven's ransom.
Amen. I hear someone in the congregation saying, one song? Just one song? For him, it's only one song? It's only one song? I'm just asking. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I'm glad I'm hearing that song for the second time today, a solo song, song that will end divine service. That's one of my favorite songs. The first time I heard that song was at a crusade many, many years ago. So that's a cruise, that's a save people, for Jesus kind of song. You know that, right?
Yes, yeah. I know. But you know, this was one of the songs I heard as a little child growing up. Like, Grandpa used to sing this song to us all the time. I remember a few years ago, we did a program, and things were falling apart for us. And this song brought home the entirety of the program that we wanted to portray without portraying the entire program. I don't know how God allowed this to happen through the one song, but Granville, you should have been there. This song, if I did this song alone, me reach a heaven long time.
Amen. Okay.
Me reach a heaven long time.
Amen. You know, the one thing I appreciate about that song, as young man sung the first verse, I just remember this one was coming to church. There was absolutely no traffic on the road. I was like, this can't be the same traffic that takes me 30 minutes from here to Trafalgar Road in the evenings. And I was like, yeah, man, a long time Jesus will come. So while you're hugging Jesus and the whole works, I don't know, me just gonna probably just fly up and down the streets by myself, because trust me, for me, that's one of the greatest joys ever, just to be alone on the road. So that's what I'll be doing for my 1,000 years. Now, 1,000 years is like a day, and I wonder if you know that.
Yes, but so, Granville, that kind of sound weird. You don't have nobody where you want to look for in a heaven for go talk to or something, because that kind of sound selfish. By yourself, I walk up and down. Remember, you know, we are going to live with selfish behavior down here, you know? How we are going to heaven.
He that is with me hath not left me alone, sister. Just wanted to know that. Amen. Now, for our next song, we speak about the king is coming. Now, the keynote singer for this evening, they will sing in a song, but the scripture that correlates with that for me comes from Job 19, verses 25 through 27, and it says, "For I know that my Redeemer lives, and he shall stand at the last on the earth. And after my skin is destroyed, this I know, that in my flesh I shall see God." And verse 27, I love how the New King James Version puts it. It says, "Whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall be old and not another. How my heart yearns within me." Ladies and gentlemen, I invite the keynotes to say, we shall see
Jesus.
And you know, when you almost say Jesus, you can hug him and kiss him and the whole works.
Thousands were fed. passion as he raised up the dead. One son of
in here by the name of Kevin.
Kevin? Who is she? We don't know. I was told to give you a scripture. The scripture says, he that endureth to the end shall be saved. In other words, if you're planning to leave, don't leave. I don't know why. I'm just a messenger, right? I'm just a messenger.
Yes, and I think they have something for her at the end.
I'm not sure about that one there.
I think so, but she has to be here to get whatever is at the end for her.
The scripture says we speak that which we know, and I don't know about that.
Well, so. I can speak because I know of it. So, if she is not here, she cannot receive what is at the end for her to receive.
All right. You're tired.
Hush. But guess what? We're on a journey, so we always are gonna get tired, booby. The road are gonna get rough and it's gonna get tough. But guess what? We're going together. Not true, hand in hand, we're going to heaven, right? And
amen. I don't know who cut our mind. Maybe that was, you know, just a sign for us to get straight into the next song. You know?
But funny enough, after it start work again.
Hey man, that's how God works, man, you know? All right, so the next person is going to come to sing us two songs. But you know, interestingly, what the scripture says that we are supposed to tell of our testimony, correct?
Yes.
What is our testimony? What's the one thing that we say? We always can say, oh, remember when God did do this.
Yes.
Don't it?
Yes, I remember.
You remember?
Yes, I remember.
All right. And when we see God's goodness in us, what does that tell us? That we are what?
I don't know.
Children of God, that God cares for us.
It does.
All right.
Sorry. My brain.
So blew. Now, we're going to invite Sister Suzette Rowe to sing two songs for us. I remember.
And Orphans of God.
Amen.
Hi again, everybody. In the darkest hour, when I cannot breathe, fear is on my chest. The weight of the world's on me. Everything is crashing down. Everything I had known. When I wonder if I'm all alone, I remember. I remember. You have always been faithful to me. Above all the lies, I know you can make a way. I've seen giants fall, I've seen mountains move, I've seen what is part because of you. I remember, you are. I can't stop thinking about your goodness. I can't stop thinking about your goodness.
He
not been broken. Who here among us is without guilt or pain? So who often abandoned by our transgressions? If such a thing as grace exists, then grace was made for lives like this. There are no strangers, there are no outcasts, there are no orphans of God. So many fallen, but hallelujah, there are no orphans of God. Come me on a wanted and find affection. Come all ye weary, come and lay down your hands. Come me unworthy, you are my brother. If such a thing as grace exists, then grace was made for
Amen. That song made me a bit teary-eyed on the outside, because I remember the scripture says that it asks, can a mother forget her suckling child? And the scripture says, yes, you know, we have seen it. But then the response was, but God can never forget you. And oftentimes when we have fallen, and we believe that we have fallen from grace, we tend to believe that God has given up on us. But here's the thing, because we are not orphans, we are actually his children, we can rest assured that, guess what, he still loves us and he still cares for us. Amen. What one for here, Mike? You have anything you want to say to your brother-in-law? Well, ladies and gentlemen, someone asked earlier if it was one song, right, Ben? So, of course, we have for him to come and sing for him again. And the song that they will be singing...
I am the way, the truth, and the light.
Yes, John what?
No, John chapter 14, verse 6.
Okay, they will sing a song about truth.
Yeah.
And about marching. And, you know, if Jesus is the truth, then Deuteronomy 31, verse 8 makes sense. But the Lord is the one who is marching before you. He is the one who will be with you. He won't let you down. He won't abandon you. Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, for him.
His birth was of a virgin, and some think his miracles can be explained away, and some say that he was just a good man, that even though he died, he wasn't really raised.
Skeptics rise and speak their lies. Truth is marching on. Truth is marching on. Down the corridors of time, invincible, divine, until all.
There will always be cynics and scoffers. Our faith has always had its noisy enemy.
They will rise up,
but only for one moment, as we see evidence through the centuries.
Jesus Christ, the way, the life, truth is marching on. Truth is marching on. Down the corridors of time, invincible, divine, until all.
Divine, until all that falls is finally gone.
marching on. No matter what, no matter what the world may say, no matter how best persons may try to change the word, the truth will always remain. We have to remain there with it. We know the sacrifice that God has made for us. We heard from the pastor this morning. He placed it in such a very picturesque way of what he did and how we should really appreciate what he did. Be it known, nobody else could have done it. Which is why we can say, worthy is the lamb that was slain.
Hear the cries of the shackled from the onset of time. For the chains of defeat, there's no key. I see the tears of the broken. Hear the cries of the slaves. Is there no one worthy to set us free? Then the crying, as the chorus rings out, the shackled released from their chain. Thousands of voices are ringing the song. Worthy the lamb that was slain. Worthy.
Amen.
Amen. Just imagine what your life would have been without Christ. I know it's really difficult for we imagine.
True. It is.
But imagine if we were, even in this present moment, able to feel the guilt of our sins. We look in the world and we see so many persons who have committed suicide buckling under the weight of depression. Because we're in Christ, we do not feel half of the guilt that we're supposed to feel. Now, imagine if there was no Jesus. We wouldn't be here today. But because there is a Christ, and he was worthy. You see, the Spirit of Prophecy writing says that when the time came for Christ to come, the angels themselves presented themselves. They did not want the loving commander of heaven to lay himself in the dust for us. Mm-hmm. You see, it did not say that after he laid on his life, he was worthy. He was worthy, and hence why he laid down his life. And Sister White, looking into the future, she said that when we're in heaven, all the crowns, everything that we are going to gain, we're going to cast him down at his feet and worship him and say, worthy is the Lamb. Because he is worthy is the reason why we are worthy. Amen.
Amen.
And we give thanks.
Sir Granville, you still think you go walk up and down by yourself same way? After all of that?
We're not going to walk, we're going to fly the scripture, say we're going to have wings or something like that.
But you won't be by yourself, though. That's
as
the
I
thing.
Said before.
You're going to be so grateful that.
Really and truly, I really want to see Jesus here. But me really want to discuss things with my guardian angel because I've been here for 30 something years and I don't know how much longer I have. And me really want to know all about those what if moments. And after you tell me about them, I want to hear about them 100 times. I mean, well, me await my time because, you know, me book my appointment with Jesus. Because I say, everybody are rushing up. Me, honestly, I've prayed about this. I say, Father God, I want some time with Jesus by myself. And nobody now get jealous because jealousy won't in nobody's heart. So,
not at all.
So me not worry about it. But I do look forward to that. But, you know, patience, we have patience. By the time the patience is perfect in my heart, you know, so me wait. Keep on affecting them things, don't it? When Christ himself is made perfect in us. I know this morning the pastor told us a story about some special men in the Bible who were thrown in the fire.
Yes.
I didn't know that they survived all these centuries. Jesus! Just to meet them this evening. I know I like the fact that we'll be talking about truth this evening. One of the songs that, you know, my superstar brothers, I don't know if they want to tell us about being in the furnace with Jesus. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have the Hebrew brothers coming to sing two special songs for us. And one of them, the truth.
Is standing right.
I want
in
to sing
front
that song
you.
There with all my heart because that's one of my songs. Me can't sing it out, so I've got to sing for me. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Good evening, everybody.
The victory as
As the King of Kings was questioned by Pilate long ago, he declared his kingdom different,
not of this
world. Of this world. The kingdom for the side of truth, like none has ever been. Pilate asked,
what is true?
What is true?
What is true?
He was standing right in front of it, of him. Truth was standing right in front of him, as plain as anything could ever be. Truth was standing there for all the world to see. The way, the truth, the light, the victory. Stephen, first beloved martyr, gave up his life for him. Being stoned by angry people,
filled with revenge.
Sky. He was never alone.
No, 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 no.
He was standing right in front of it, of him. Truth was standing right
in front of him.
As plain as anything could ever be.
As plain as anything could ever be.
Truth was standing right in front of him. Standing there for all the world to see. The way, the truth, the light, the victory.
Until this very day, but the source that we should seek is
not of this
world. The truth that is revealed by God, the Spirit made it clear.
The Spirit made it clear.
Standing right in front of you, truth is standing. Plain as anything could ever be.
This song took a lot, trust me.
If it wasn't for the lighthouse, tell me where would this ship be?
There's a lighthouse on the hillside that overlooks life's seas. When I'm tossed, it sends out a light that I might see. And the light that shines in darkness now safely lit a soul. If it wasn't for the lighthouse, my ship will be no more.
Understanding is that there is a big concert back in St. Catherine tonight, and so we have to move up one of our singers for this evening. But there's a story that I forgot to tell you about why I love the song, The Truth Was Standing Right in Front of Him. It's a story of Pilate, and we know when he asked Jesus, what is truth? And the way he's described in the Desire of Ages is that he sincerely asked the question, what is truth? But then the crowd was outside chanting and ranting and doing a whole lot of things. And I like to imagine that when he asked Christ, what is truth, that Jesus was going to respond to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. But because of the crowd, he never got to hear that answer. And it reminds me so much of us and the people that we are trying to save, that the truth we are trying to present the truth, and the truth is right before them. I pray that these songs will be reminders for us as we minister for Christ this week. But, you know, the first time I ever emceed a concert, you know, I'm like, who is, I mentioned the name, I was like calling, you know, the running the order, and everyone was like, when I said Ilka Jones, everybody was like, oh, I'm just like, okay, who is this person? Well, ladies and gentlemen.
You know who it is, right?
Of course.
I just wondering, because, you know.
In Adventist culture, we have big names, we have brands, and we have big name brands. And it so works out that when it comes on to musical performance and performing for Christ, that Ilka Jones is just one of those persons. And singing two beautiful songs this evening, we just welcome him on stage so that, you know, can we know later will be greater. Correct, brother?
Yes.
Amen.
Later will be greater.
Hallelujah. So he's still getting it wrong because it's a Hilka and it's actually Hilkiah. Hilkiah Jones.
Oh, like Ezekiah?
No. But, yeah, that works as well. But it's fine. I won't charge you. Hallelujah. Just be blessed by these two numbers. In Jesus' name. I dream of a city called glory, so bright and so filled. As I enter the gates, I cried, home. The angels all met me there. They carried me from mansion to mansion, and all the sights I saw. Then I said, I want to see Jesus, the one who died for all. I bow on my knees and cried, holy, holy, I clapped my hands and sang glory, glory to the Son. I entered the gates of that city. My loved ones, they knew me well, so they took me down the streets of heaven. Hallelujah. Yes, the scenery were too many to tell. I saw Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac. I spoke with Mark, sat down with Timothy. Then I said, Timothy, I want to see my
my knees and cried, holy, oh, cried holy. Oh, thank you, Lord, holy, holy. I clapped my hands and sang glory. I sing glory, sing glory, glory. I clapped my hands and sang glory. I clapped my hands and sang glory.
Hallelujah. What a day that will be. What a day that will be when our Jesus, we shall see, when we look upon his beautiful face, the one who saved us by his grace. Come on, if you know it, I want you to sing along with me. Oh, there is coming a day. Thank you. Yeah. Listen. There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the skies, no more tears to dim their eyes. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day that will be. Come on, everybody, help me praise. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Hallelujah, thank you, Lord. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens, no burdens to bear, no more sickness, no more pain, no more crying over there. And forever we will be, yes, with the one who died for you and for me. What a day, glorious day that will be. The one who saved me by his grace, when he takes majesty, glorious day, glad to be. Say what a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day, what a beautiful day. Oh, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. What a day. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you.
What a day indeed that will be. If we have been paying attention from morning until now and looking at the theme for the week, for the service, it's pillars of our faith. And we learned that the pillars of our faith consist of six things. Can anybody name the six things? What? Faith, hope, love, peace. What are the pillars of our faith as Seventh-day Adventists?
Is this one of those questions where there are no wrong answers?
No, there are no wrong answers, but one is the Sabbath.
Oh,
one
I
is
knew that.
Spirit of prophecy.
Yes.
The third one is...
Peace?
No. The second coming, yes. Mm-hmm.
Immortality of the soul. The
non-immortality
of the
soul. The state of the dead
what
is the fourth one. And one more. The sanctuary, yes, the sanctuary. So there are five fundamental pillars of our faith. The sanctuary, the Sabbath, the state of the dead, second coming, and spirit of prophecy. Yes, spirit of prophecy. So I hope that as we go through this week, this today and yesterday was a learning experience for many of us, because we still don't know the fundamentals of the pillars of our faith. And it dawned on me that we're looking forward to the coming of Christ, but we are not yet ready, even though we have the tools, the resources, the everything. We take it for granted. Going into this new week, I'm asking us to renew our relationship with Christ, start studying our Bibles, start praying more, start bringing songs in our hearts. It helps to calm us, especially some of us who have road rage in traffic. And I'm now speaking about myself. I can't speak about anybody else. I'm speaking about myself here. I just want us to bring a new devotion, renew our devotion with Christ. because we're looking for that day when he shall appear and know that the Sabbath has ended. And just to close off the Sabbath, I want us to pray. Granville.
All right. Can we just, for 30 seconds, just be quiet? Close our eyes and just think of all the glorious things that God has done. You know, the Sabbath stands for so many things. One, it's a constant reminder that God is our creator. And if he created, he can recreate, and he will recreate. And while holy time has ended, we can still rest assured that we are still in the holy presence of God. And our Father who art in heaven, I want to thank you so much for everything that you have given unto us, especially this blessed Sabbath day. It's not something that we wield before, you know, our other brothers and sisters in Christ. This is not something that we use as an excuse to escape from labor, you know, as the Egyptians would have accused the children of Israel. But it's a constant reminder of your love for us, of the peace that you have to give and of the rest that is to come. So we acknowledge the day that has ended. I want to thank you for the day that has begun. And as we move forward into a new week, and we start that with more singing and more songs of praise to you, we pray and we ask that what you have in store for us will be no lesser than that which you have done for us in weeks past. In Christ's blessed and holy name I pray. Amen.
Amen, amen. So with us this afternoon, we have a voda, and they are going to be singing for us right now.
They told us two songs, but I'm not sure which one, whether it be Homesick or Child Forgiven, but they'll, and we invite a voda, yes?
A voda, yes. Still not hearing us? You're here now? Okay.
What's your name again, Kevin, it is? Come here.
Yes.
You already wait so long, you know, might as well just come and just do a mister right now. It looks so lovely today.
Thank you.
What's so special about today? That's it? Nothing more? You sure?
Did something happen over the week?
Yes. What happened?
What happened?
Was your birthday the entire week? Oh. When was your birthday? On Wednesday the 23rd. You were 23rd on the 23rd? Don't tell us.
Mm-mm.
I wanted to.
Oh. Yes.
Well, go ahead.
We get to understand that this is a special day for a very special person. I'm not going to say that we were hijacked into singing it because this is just a special song.
Happy birthday to you. This is your day. Always is for you. We love you every way. This is your day. Happy birthday to you, to you, to you. Happy birthday to you.
So young.
You're so young. Age is a number. Don't you stop having fun. This is your day, your day. Happy birthday to you, to you, to you.
Happy birthday.
No, on to the Lord's business.
Yes, 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 yes. Happy Sunday, everybody. Come on, happy Sunday, everybody.
Happy Sunday.
Come on, can we praise the Lord on Sunday? Yeah, man, the Sabbath has gone, but we have entered a new week. And let me tell you something. This week probably going to be hard. Because something I realize is that the week them very hard and very tiring. We were supposed to practice last night, and when them tell me that they're tired and now come up and say, praise Jesus, I can't sleep. But it is good to know that this is not our final home, not you. We're looking forward to a better day. Are you homesick to see Jesus, somebody? Come on, let's praise him. Let us praise him.
Tum, 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 tum.
There's a light in the window and the table set in splendor. Someone standing by the open door.
Open door.
I can see the crystal river. Oh, I must be near forever. And I have never been this homesick before. I see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. I can see my father standing at the door. This world has been wilderness. I'm headed for deliverance.
I have never been this homesick before.
Listen, sweet faces, they're all familiar. No one's old and feeble anymore. Oh, when this lonesome heart is crying, think I'll spread my wings for flying. But I've never been this homesick before. And I see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. I can see my father standing at the door. This world has been wilderness. I'm headed for deliverance.
Lord, I've never been this homesick before.
Somebody, come on, come on, come on, come on. He is worthy. God is good. All the time, God is good.
Mm-hmm. Come on, you have to turn together for this song, you know. You can't just sit there.
I thought I had my bases covered.
I have to dance.
My destiny was in control. But I didn't have my bases covered.
Let us try this again.
Let's try it again. So when it's nice, you have to do it twice. Come, Brother Forbes, do it again. Do it again, Brother Forbes.
But I had my bases covered. My destiny was in control. But I see I could never reach perfection until I hit that puddle in the road.
And after that, I thought my life was over.
But Jesus had a different point of view. All I did was confess, and Jesus did the rest. Thank God I'm still made brand new.
You're looking at a child forgiven. You're looking at a soul set free. You're looking at a pardoned prisoner who's walking out in liberty. I'm standing here because of wondrous grace. My sins are in the deepest sea. He washed me clean somehow. So what you see him now is a happy, happy child set free.
Now what you see is not a perfect person. What you see is not a faultless soul. What you see is someone that was broken until the hand of Jesus made me whole.
Now what you see is not a finished product. And what you see might sometimes miss the mark. But I know my Father's eyes see only His sweet prize.
The perfect holy children that we are. Yes, you're looking at a child forgiven. You're looking at a soul set free. You're looking at a pardoned prisoner who's walking down in liberty. I'm standing here because of wondrous grace. My sins are in the deepest sea. He washed me clean somehow. So what you see him now is a happy, happy child set free. Yes, you're looking at a child forgiven. You're looking at a soul set free. You're looking at a pardoned prisoner who's walking out in liberty. I'm standing here because of wondrous grace. My sins are in the deepest sea. He washed me clean somehow. So what you see in now is a happy, happy child. Happy, happy child. Happy, happy child set free.
Everybody. Woo! Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
We can just start the social from now, don't?
I know, right?
We can just start the social from now. But warm up your voices. Yes? Amen?
Amen, amen, amen.
I wasn't really speaking to you. I was asking voices to warm up their voices. Because the next couple of songs that we'll be hearing...
It's going
be
to be voices.
You see, I'm meeting some of these groups for the first time.
Really? Which rock you have been hiding under?
Never really used to, you know. A long time I really got church, but in a recent talk about church and,
Okay.
God is good. So I'm meeting these superstars for the first time and I'll be inducted once again into Adventist culture, which is the most beautiful and amazing thing.
Amen.
Because whatever we start here, we're going to continue when we get all the way over there. Okay. Amen.
Oh, yes.
Voices, amen. Take us away.
Bye.
One, two.
Bye. Oh, yeah. This is good. Thank you. Happy Sabbath. Oh, no. Happy Sunday, everybody.
Happy belated Sabbath,
everybody.
Happy belated
Sabbath.
Once there was a broken heart. You know, says lamented in. Wait, hold on.
Yeah.
Play that song again. Yeah.
One.
Once there was a holy place, evidence of God's embrace. I can almost see mercy's face pressed against the veil. Looking on with longing eyes, mercy must have realized that once his blood was sacrificed, freedom would prevail. As the sky grew dark and the earth begins to shake, with justice no longer in way, mercy came running like a prisoner set free, past all my failures to the point of my knees. Sin that I carried was all I could see. When I could not reach mercy, mercy came running to me. Once there was a broken heart, way too human from the start. All the years left it torn apart, hopeless and afraid. Walls I never meant to build left this prisoner unfulfilled. Freedom called, but even still, it seems so far away. I was bound by the chains from the wages of my sin. Just when I felt like giving in, mercy came running like a prisoner set free, past all my failures to the point of my knees. Sin that I carried was all I could see. When I could not reach mercy, mercy came running to me. Sometimes I still feel so far, so far from where I really should be. Reach and leave calls to my heart. Mercy came running like a prisoner set free, past all my failures to the point of my knees. Sin that I carry was all I could see. When I could not reach mercy, mercy came running like a prisoner set free, past all my failures to the point of my knees. Sin that I carried was all I could see. Mercy came running. Yeah. Point of my knees. Sin that I carried was all I could see. When I could not reach mercy, mercy came running.
That's all right,
He came down to my level when I couldn't get up to his. With a strong arm, he lifted me up, showed me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living
That's what he came down for. He came down to my level when I couldn't get up to his. With a strong arm, he lifted me up. He showed me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what he came down for. If you're looking for contentment in the things that you can't see, you're gonna have some disappointments. So won't you listen to me, please? Because I know about a savior. He came down to be a man, and when he left, he sent his spirit. He made me everything I am. He came down to my level when I couldn't get up to his. With a strong arm, he lifted me up to show me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what he came down for. Sometimes I make decisions that later I regret, but the Lord keeps on assuring me he's not finished with me yet. I don't worry about tomorrow. I don't worry about yesterday. I don't worry about this crazy world, 'cause I found a better way. He came down to my level when I couldn't get up to his. With a strong arm, he lifted me up to show me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what he came down for. He came down to my level,
yeah,
when I couldn't get up to his. With a strong arm, he lifted me up. Show me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what he came down for. He came down to my level when I couldn't get up to his. With a strong arm, he lifted me up. Show me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what he came down for. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what he came down for. That's what he came down for.
Amen. I was checking on, so amen is like my mic check. Oh, what a Sunday. Hey, this has been one of the best Sundays I've had in a very long, long time. Amen?
Amen.
Now we have two more songs of praise. You know, but as they were singing, I said, you know what? It's one thing, you know. Singers will sing and preachers will preach. But I won't be preaching today. So at this point in time, I invite, guess who?
The Hebrew Brothers.
Well, since you don't want them to come sing again, why not? The Hebrew Brothers. Which song will be singing for us this evening?
Robe of White.
Well, the mics are on that side, so I'll just, you know, do a little talking while they get. Robe of White. You know, so for me, a part of my Christian journey is I keep having these eureka moments. First, I mean, I really like Jesus. Then when I found out what Jesus is, I was like, man, what a guy. And then, after struggling with my Christianity, I found out about the robe of righteousness, which is the robe of white. I was like, whoa, what a guy. So, you know, it's just interesting that salvation is so easy, so simple. There's nothing that we can do to be saved. And I hope that as we listen to the robe of white this evening, we'll not only hear it, but we will wear it. Hebrew Brothers.
Oh.
meet my Jesus there, it will be so grand. When I get to that land in my robe of white, I will fly away.
First I hear the trumpet sound, all the saints in heaven bound. We will cross over Jordan wide, stop and view the other side. And I'll see those holy hills, and my mansion is built. I'll be the first one in the line, I'll see my name in the book of life.
Oh, in my robe of white, I will fly away to that land so fair. Meet my Jesus there, it will be so grand. When I get to that land in my robe of white, I will fly away.
Now for our final, and I think Cheyenne probably, when she was putting the program together, she did this one on purpose. The final song for this evening, before we invite Humble to do
Vespers.
I don't want to call it Vespers, but probably our first family worship for the week. But, because Sabbath don't, it can't be Vespers anymore. I don't know.
Worship.
I only know Vespers when it comes on to Sabbath. I don't know. I don't even know what Vespers mean. I just know Vespers mean to close off the Sabbath. That's what I know.
Or begin the Sabbath.
But we have.
It's keynote, right?
Keynotes.
I'm not a singer. But it is done, and I hope this is a song. Is it a song?
Yeah.
It is. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a song.
It's done.
It was midnight at Golgotha, in the middle of today. Every sin was laid upon him as the Father turned away. In the silence of that moment, Jesus lifted one last breath. It is finished. Then he died. It is done. The price has been paid. It is done. Provision's been made. It is done. The work has been completed. Satan is defeated. The victory's been won. It is done.
Shadows of some pain or past regret. Does your heart feel like it's breaking? Oh, a shame you can't forget.
The grace of God
is waiting. Where the Lamb was crucified, you are forgiven. When he cried,
it is done.
price has been paid. It is done. Provision's been made. It is done. The work has been completed. Satan is defeated. The victory.
Invite humble to, but you know, as a song, one of the key things that came to my mind was, it's already finished. It's like you're going to an exam where you know all the answers. All you have to do is just show up, wait till the 1.5 hour finish, and you walk out and you pass the exam. That's how complete our salvation is. And as humble comes to close this evening's session, I just want us to think how complete our salvation is in Christ. And the only thing that Christ has asked us to do in return is to just go and tell others this good news, that everything is done already. Humble.
One, two.
Mind check. One, two.
One, two. Ah, nice.
Okay. One, two.
This is good.
When the trumpet sound, I'm gonna wear a crown.
I'm gonna wear a crown.
I'm gonna wear.
shall wear a robe and crown.
I'm gonna wear a 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 crown.
When the trumpet sounds.
When the trumpet sounds.
When the trumpet sounds.
When the trumpet sounds. I will surely wear a crown. I shall wear a crown. We shall wear a robe and crown. The resurrection morning,
when all the
dead in Christ
shall rise.
Shall rise.
Shall rise. I have a new body.
Soon as my feet strike Zion, lay down my heavy burden, put on my robe and glory. Shall tell them that story. Soon as I can see Jesus, tell him all about my trouble. Put on my robe and glory. Shout, shout,
we're gonna tell him now.
Shout, shout,
well, all the
earth bows down to him. Shout, shout, shout.
Well, all the earth
bows down to him.
Yes, all the
earth bows down to shout, shout, shout.
And we sing praise to you, oh, oh,
praise to you.
And we sing praise to your name.
Hey! Soon as my feet strike, 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 lay down my heavy burden, put on my robe in glory, shout and tell him my story. Soon as I can see Jesus, tell him all about my trouble. Put on my robe in glory, shout, shout, tell him the story. We shall wear a robe and crown.
Through Instagram the other day, see?
Mm-hmm.
And I heard a pastor say something. I'm going to share it with you.
Share it with us.
He went to the mall with his three daughters.
Mm-hmm.
He gave $50 to one, $50 to another one,
mm-hmm.
and he walked with the smallest one. Send the two big ones to go and look for what they want and buy at the smallest one. He mm-hmm. gave the smallest one $50 as well. But she was with her father. Mm. As they walked, Daddy, can I have that? Sure, no problem. Daddy, can I have that? Sure, no problem. Mm. And by the time she was finished with all that she wanted, it passed the $50.
Mm-hmm.
The other two came back with $50 worth of goods. But the youngest got a whole lot more. Why? Because she was with her father.
Mercy.
Now, what happens when we are away from our father? It profits us way less
yeah.
than when we are with him.
Message. Message. Wow. Wow. So in this as we close off the Sabbath and enter into a week full of things that will cause us to spend our own $50. And a lot of times, spending that $50, we don't get value for our money. We don't get value for what the effort that we put into the week, sometimes we don't see the reward for it. However, as Uncle Errol says, it is important for us to remember that we have to stick close to the source. So whatever you go through this week, because the trials will come. We had a high day in Zion, and I'm sure we were blessed from morning until now. We know it, and the devil knows it too. And because he knows it, he will do all in his power to distract us and to make us spend our $50 and not get the value for what we want out of this week. But be reminded that except we stick to this source, there will be no sort of sustenance. Amidst the trials, amidst the temptation, amidst the situations that may come our way, let us stick to the source. Mm-hmm. Let us stick to the source. There's a little song that we like to sing. Some of you may know it, some may not. However, it's very easy, very simple. It says, from the rising of the sun, you've given me everything I need. From before this world began, you knew my name. You are Alpha and Omega. You made the world and all the stars in place. You are mighty, you are strong, and I bless your name. The chorus is, I love to worship, I love to honor, I love to lift up your holy name. So let us worship together as we sing praises to the Most High God.
From the rising of the sun, you've given me everything I need. From before this world began, you knew my name. You are Alpha and Omega. You made the world and hung the stars in place. You are mighty, you are strong, and I bless your name. I love to worship, I love to honor, lift up your holy name. You are my Father, you're my provider. I love to lift up your holy name. Say, I love to worship,
I love to worship,
I love to honor,
I love to honor,
I love to lift up,
I love to lift up
your holy name,
your holy name.
You are Father,
Father,
you're my provider,
you're my provider.
I love to lift up,
I love to lift up
your holy name,
your holy name.
I love to worship,
I love to worship,
I love to honor,
I love to honor,
I love to lift up,
I love to lift up
your holy name,
your holy name.
You are my Father,
you are my Father,
you're my provider,
you're my provider.
I love to lift up,
I love to lift up
your holy name,
your holy.
You are the owner of my heart, you're the restorer of my soul. Send your anointing now and fill this holy place.
Your holy name,
your holy name. You are the
Stand with us while we take it to the Lord in prayer. Let us pray. Father, it's been a long day, a good day. It's a long day. But we are happy for sustenance. We are happy that we could come into your presence free of charge. Free from any sort of maliciousness, free from any sort of fear, and just come boldly before you as humbly as we can, knowing, Father, that you are God of all. You created all and you sustain all. The Bible says from eternity past to eternity future, you are God. So we acknowledge the fact that you are all powerful. We acknowledge the fact that you are unknowing. We acknowledge the fact that you are everywhere. And we are thankful that you are everywhere, O God, even in our darkest, deepest, most sorrowful times, Father, you are there. May we be reminded of that fact as we go through another week that we don't even know how it's going to be. We have no clue as to the sort of trials that are going to come our way this week. But by faith, we profess, Father, that you who know beginning from end and you who have our best interest at heart, you will deliver, you will provide, and you will take us through this week. May when we get to this point next week, we may look back at all of the trials, of all of the stresses, of all the struggles that had come our way. We may look back in hope and in promise and in victory, knowing that we gained victory by you, Jesus. Take us safely home. Take us safely throughout this week. Be our guard. Keep us from all evil. And may at the end of all time, we may see each other as we are seeing each other now in heaven. This is our prayer. This is our asking. In no other name but yours, Jesus. Amen.
Right. So I heard that there's somebody that's celebrating a birthday today. Tash. Where is Tash? It's not today.
Tash.
It's coming up. Okay. All right. But it's today for us.
Indeed. Indeed.
Yes. It's today.
Tomorrow.
We're
Tash
in tomorrow.
Is when it's a birthday.
It's Sunday. Yeah, man.
It's when? It's Monday?
Almost.
So it's tomorrow because we're in a Sunday now, right?
Yeah, Sunday. Yeah. Sunday. The evening and the morning were the first.
Right, yeah. Indeed.
Right. So, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
That's what we gonna do. With a smile on every face as we pass through.
Oh yeah.
We just here to
spread love.
That's what we gonna do.
Spread love.
With a smile on every face as we pass through.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. We must learn to love ourselves, yeah, so that we can share this love with someone else. And I know sometimes you're gonna feel, but don't stay there for too long,
cause we'll be here to help you come around.
Thanks for watching our channel. Please remember to subscribe, like and share all our videos. You can find us on Facebook, Instagram or Twitter at New Kingston SDA.